executive and the members of the press. We have a statement for today, which is headed "Promote People-Driven Dialogue Process." And I'll read it. The Executive Committee of the National Council of Churches of Kenya has met here at Jumuiya Conference and Country Home Remove for the last 2 days to transact statutory business and reflect on matters of national concern. We recognize that for a long time, Kenyans have suffered due to conflict arising from ethnic and political divisions. Efforts and interventions in the past have not facilitated the required reconciliation for redemption of the nation. There is a desperate need for a redemptive process that is premised on 3 principles. 1, reconciling the nation. 2, renewal of national values. And recovery and reconstruction of the economy and service delivery. We appreciate that this is the approach that God upholds, as he declared in Isaiah chapter 1, verse 18. It says, "Come, let us reason together, says the Lord." With this in mind, we wish to share the following message with all Kenyans. Consolation for the destructive floods. This executive committee is deeply saddened by the report of the high number of deaths, injuries, and destruction of properties and livelihoods due to the raging floods being experienced in different parts of the country. Most touching was the death of more than 60 people in West Pokot. It took time to pray for the families of the bereaved and for all those who are affected, that God will grant quick recovery for health and their livelihoods. To promote brotherly kindness and support for all those affected by the floods, the NCCK pleads with Kenyans, believers and congregants of our member churches, and all the well-wishers to donate generously to the people of West Pokot and those affected by the floods. Donations can be sent to the NCCK PayPal number 519-900. And the account is floods. Number 2, we have a second national dialogue conference. The executive committee is pleased to have been part of the national dialogue process, spearheaded by the Dialogue Reference Group, or DRG. Through the process, we held a national dialogue conference in September 2018, followed by 44 county dialogue conferences in all the in the 44 counties in Kenya between November 2018 and August 2019. The county dialogue conferences led Kenyans of all walks of life an opportunity to analyze the issues that affected us and make recommendations on how to resolve them at the national and county levels. The resolutions of these conferences have been compiled into a draft national dialogue consensus agreement, which will be received, reviewed, and launched by the second national dialogue conference to be held on December 4th and 5th, 2019. Through the National Dialogue Consensus Agreement, we, together with all Kenyans, will present a roadmap to a cohesive and prosperous nation. In this regard, this executive committee welcomes and appreciates the release of the report of the Building Bridges Initiative Task Force. We will study the report and continue participating in the process of healing the nation. In conclusion, we call upon all Kenyans to hear the word of God recorded in Isaiah chapter 61 and verse 4, which is a promise for what happens when people turn to God and he brings restoration. It says that they will rebuild the ancient ruins, and restore the places long devastated. They will renew the ruined cities that have been devastated for generations. Let us embrace dialogue and reconciliation, and God will visit our nation to restore it. But let us remember to embrace justice for all, so that God looks on us with favor. We therefore urge all Kenyans to actively participate in the national and local level dialogue processes organized by different actors for the betterment of our nation. We take this moment to wish all Kenyans a Merry Christmas and a blessed and God-filled New Year 2020. Thank you very much.